The futures, Michael, by the way, seem to be as volatile as the Federal Reserve.
Yeah.
And I bring that up for a reason. Do you believe this is a steady Eddie Fed?
You know, I'll tell you, it's been quite a journey from over the last 6 months in the bond market, and also, you know, for people like us who are watching the Fed all the time. You know, if you remember back in October, early October, we were far from neutral. The bond market was at, you know, the yields on 10-year going up to 3.25. It looked like they were going to go up to 3.5 and 4. And the narratives have completely reversed. Now, you expect volatility in the bond market and in the money markets, but what you don't necessarily expect is so much volatility in the Fed, as you were just suggesting. And I think it's been very interesting because, you know, what is ultimately that different in the economy from September through December through the March FOMCs? You know, obviously some of the global growth has continued to weaken. Some of there's a growing realization that 2019 and 20 are a little slower. But, you know, the overall picture here is still pretty good. Inflation is not escalating to the upside, but it's kind of holding together.
Let's give you a multiple choice test. Are you ready for one at 5:54 in the morning?
Sure.
The yield curve slightly inverted and bond yields are at 2.4% for two reasons. A, the world fears a global slowdown, and therefore people are coming into bonds to find a safe haven. Or B, there are some technical buying going on to fund short-term deficits, and it has nothing to do with global recession fears.
A little bit of all of the above and a couple of other things. But look, there's one thing that's very clear, which is that as it relates to the Treasury market, the 10-year Treasury yield, only one thing that has mattered over the last several months, and that is the money markets curve. In other words, what is the Fed going to do in hiking, right? Things like supply demand have gotten thrown out the window. Things like the term premium is at record low levels here. We've talked a little bit about that in the past. The concept of, you know, even like, you know, the inflation story, you know, there's some tracking of inflation break-evens, and that has been almost sort of disregarded. Inflation break-evens have actually rallied dramatically since December, but the bond market seems to have it completely ignored that. I think there's going to be a little bit of a readjustment process going on, and actually I think there's a reasonable case the bond market's going to start selling off in the coming weeks.
And yields go back up.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.